Hello, I'm Sheriff Matt Kendall. CAL FIRE released a report that stated by September 8th of 2020, California had already had more fires burn, more acres, than any year since CAL FIRE started recording these types of figures. We still have months to go before we can expect rain. So today, I'm going to talk to you about not preparing for an evacuation, but instead, what to do when you return home. We want to get you home safely. It sounds simple. We lift an evacuation order and you just go home. Well, it's not quite that simple. The first thing I'd like to ask you to do when you arrive home is to check for the smell of gas. If you smell gas, leave your home immediately and call PG&E or your gas provider. Have them do an inspection for you. Then before you get too comfortable, take a look around the outside of your property. Use extreme caution around trees, power poles, any other tall objects that may have been weakened or become unstable due to the fire. And definitely don't touch any down power lines. If you see any down power lines, call PG&E and ask them to come inspect this for you immediately. Look for any smoke or sparks on your property. Look on your roof, look in the gutters and throughout the house. Look for any hidden embers. Don't drink or use the water from your faucet until you're sure the water supply hasn't been damaged or polluted as a result of fire between you and the source of the water supply. If you have a well, please check the well and the pipes leading to your home. If you live on a municipal water, please contact the water company. Confirm the water's safe. I'd like to ask you to throw away any food that has been exposed to heat, smoke, or fire suppression water or soot. I understand this is difficult during these hard financial times where so many people have been without work, but I urge you to put your health and health of your family first. Don't take any chances. If you get home and find there's no power, check to make sure the main breaker to your house is on. If the breakers are on and the power is still not present, contact the utility company. And as always, I know you're going to use your best judgment and common sense to do what's right for you and your family. If you have any questions or concerns about returning home after a fire, please ask them below in the comments section and I'll do my best to get them answered. Thank you, and remember that we're all stronger together.